Good morning and welcome to our second lecture sa ating NSTP2. And tayo ay nagkaroon ng meeting last week, no, for the first time just to discuss about to have some class orientation and even yung ating first lecture on community concepts and community immersion. So to those who are not here, who were not here last week, I am your instructor. I'm Sir Vioren Grimaldo. And I will be I will be with you for this whole semester for our NSTP2 subject. And ang ating ang pinag-usapan last time is we defined the meaning of the community last meeting. And based on our definition, a community is a group of people with one purpose, whether living together or not living together in the same place. That's what we call community. So yung mga communities na living together, we call that as geographical, like yung mga nakatira sa barangay, yung mga magkakasama sa isang compound, that is what we call as geographical community. Well, as yung functional community ay katulad natin, no, tayo ay nakatira sa iba't ibang mga lugar, pero we have one purpose. We are gathering, excuse me, we are gathering in our MS teams, so that is considered as a functional community. Yung mga supporters ng isang politician, supporters ng isang basketball group, or ng isang yung mga fans club, that's what we considered as a functional community. At yung third naman na example or classification ay relevant. When we say relevant, pwedeng magkakasama sa isang lugar, pwedeng nakatira sa iisang lugar, pwede naman silang hindi nakatira sa iisang lugar, pero yung purpose nila is deeper. No, ang purpose nila is to change a system, to change an institution para baguhin ang perception ng tao, para magbago ng practice ng mga tao. Yun yung goal ng relevance. It can be functional or it can be geographical, pero yung goal ng relevant is to change a system, baguhin ang isang sistema. And we also discuss five elements of the community, which is the demographics or the people. Number two ay history, yung mga past events that shapes our community now. We also discussed culture last time, yung kultura, yung way of life, yung daily living, yung daily routine ng mga tao sa community, shapes the community. Another one is economics, economy. So iba-iba ang kabuhayan sa isang lugar or meron silang iba't ibang antas, no, sa kanilang economic status, no, iba't ibang levels. And lastly, we discuss about structure that can be a political structure, a social structure, or a physical structure. And we discuss also that it's important for us to have community immersion. Mahalaga na magkaroon muna tayo ng community immersion before going to before presenting a program to a community. And we shared that last time, no, yung aking kwento doon sa aming livelihood business na ginawa, no, livelihood program na ginawa sa mga nanay ng Masinloc Zambales, yung paggawa ng kitchen, pero hindi namin nalaman, hindi namin naunawaan kung ano talaga yung profile nila, saan sila nakatira, sino yung mga kasama nila sa community, and even with their knowledge with livelihood. Kaya hindi namin ito na ituro sa kanila, lumipas lang ang ilang araw, huminto na agad ang business, ang negosyo. So you can see, it's important for us to know our community para makapag-provide tayo ng suitable program. Suitable, ibig sabihin, programa na swak sa kanilang problema, swak sa kanilang mga issues, and even a sustainable program na even though if our presence in the community is already finished or if we will be leaving the community, patuloy pa rin, continuous pa rin yung community work. So it's a sustainable one. So today, after discussing the community immersion, ngayon naman ang pag-aaralan natin are the processes. Ano ba yung mga proseso ng community immersion? This should be done during face-to-face na setup kasi, no, sa NSTP. But because of our setting as an online virtual class, we will be doing a lot of modifications here. And I will be sharing in the coming weeks kung paano yung magiging community work natin, kung gano'ng kadaming panahon, kung ilang beses tayo lalabas, or kung paano yung ating setup, ano yung programa natin. And because we are going to a transition from a virtual to a face-to-face type of community work, what we'll be doing is we will be doing a lot of modifications here. So baka may mga processes that we will not be able to follow para hindi tayo maging mahirapan, no, with the process, no, because this is a tedious work. This is I think 3 to 5 meetings ito eh sa field, but because of our situation we will limit it maybe just 1 meeting or just few meetings, or kung paano yung magiging setup natin for our community work. We will discuss that in the coming weeks. So this will be the process of community immersion. So let's start with pre-immersion. When we say pre-immersion, pre, no, prefix, pre-pandemic, pre-immersion, ibig sabihin bago, no, bago ang immersion, bago tayo lumabas, bago tayo mag-provide ng community program, what are we going to do? So we need to have pre-immersion, parang preparation, ayan, paghahanda natin before going to a community. So sa pre-immersion, ang bagay na mahalagang gawin natin is area selection. We need to choose where to go. Where are we going to go? So we have here 6 considerations to follow. Number 1, select marginalized sectors. When we say marginalized sectors, I mentioned last time that these are the deprived, depressed, and underprivileged communities. But when we say DDU, or deprived, depressed, and underprivileged communities, or marginalized sectors, hindi lamang sila yung nangangailangan ng finances. Communities also who are in need of their other aspects of their living, or yung mga communities na merong mga pangangailangan na ma-uplift ang kanilang welfare and kanilang well-being. Ang mga batang nahihirapan sa kanilang pag-aaral, that can be our target for our community work. We can do tutorial classes. By that, they don't need finances, but they need something na maturuan sila sa kanilang pag-aaral. So marginalized sectors, hindi lamang siya limited or hindi lamang siya exclusive doon sa mga communities na may pangangailangan financial. So marginalized sectors. Number 2, local communities must be willing to work and support community projects. You will discern this. Malalaman mo kung yung community ay hindi supportive. Pero sa case kasi natin, pupunta muna tayo sa barangay leaders or sa community leaders. So we will have now a hint kung supportive yung community o hindi sa mga gatong programs. May mga community kasi na hindi sila supportive, hindi sila willing to work. Anong example niyan? Siguro mabibigay ko na example yung mga sa pagtuturo namin sa mga bata, ang challenging pag yung community ay hindi open. Bukod sa onti lang yung dumadalo, pag nag-house to house kami to ask for participants, the parents are not very eager na makipag-usap sa amin, or even though that we put our efforts in asking for participants or gathering the kids, onti lang yung dumadalo. At yung ibang mga bata, hindi interested. So by that, we can see that they're not willing to work and they're not willing to support our community work. So our option is to choose another site. Mamili na lang ng isang lugar. Maybe same place, pero ibang location. Baka sa kabilang kanto, pa tayo makahanap ng supportive na community. So you can discern that. Mararamdaman nyo yung community ay hindi supportive. Number 3, consider the needs and resources within the capability of the students and community partners. Doon muna tayo sa community partners. Halimbawa, binanggit natin na ang isang community nais nila ng livelihood program, at dapat yung ibibigay natin na livelihood program, nandoon sa loob nila yung resources. At nabanggit din natin last week, what we can do siguro, if they have a lot of bananas in their community, we can consider a banana as a raw material for their livelihood. So what we wanted, kunyari, is a banana cake. Banana cake, yung paggawa ng banana cake. So we will be teaching them how to do banana cake. But banana cake needs materials, like kailangan niya ng oven. Ang community na pupuntahan natin, based on our observation, they don't have their ovens. So paano? Paano tayo makakapag-bake kung walang oven yung mga tao? Should we choose another program or should we choose another product? Kasi hindi natin matutupad yung banana cake. Kung meron namang mga paraan din na magluto ng banana cake gamit ang mga steamers, yung mga no-bake, banana cake, yung mga steam cakes, may mga ganyan ng mga recipes ngayon eh. At yung steamer, mas ano yun, mas accessible sa tao kasi usually yung mga rice cooker, 'di ba, may steamer na nakasama yon, or meron naman pwede naman mag-improvise sa malaking kawa, tapos magi-improvise sila ng mga patungan para hindi lang malubog sa tubig yung mga yung ating lalagyanan, no? Pero yung ganong option. So kung ganun, if you really wanted to teach about banana cake making at wala silang oven, choose an option na meron sila sa community. So hindi lang tayo basta-basta magbibigay ng community work, we should choose a program that is fit for their resources. Eh ito nga ang problema. Meron ba sa ating marunong gumawa ng banana cake? No? Ay sir, pag-aralan na lang muna natin sa YouTube. Pero dapat din nating malaman yung ating capacity. Kasi kung wala naman marunong sa ating gumawa ng mag-conduct ng livelihood program, kasi tayo ay psychology, IT, tsaka LIS students, di naman ako nagsistereotype, pero I assume na baka wala tayong capacity to create livelihood program for the community. So we should fit our capacity also to the program that we will be doing. So dapat medyo ano tayo, medyo maalam para when we go to them, hindi tayo nangangapa, hindi tayo yung nanood na lang tayo sir ng tutorial kung paano gumawa ng banana cake. So if that's the case, it will be hard for us to offer genuinely a program to a community because our resources or our capacity will not be able for us to do so. No? So it's important for us to consider the needs of the people and also the needs of the students or the capacity of the students. So that's the first three. Number four, places that are not saturated by other agencies. Dapat hindi lahat ng NSTP class nasa isang lugar or nasa isang public elementary school. Dapat scattered tayo. Or we will be also seeing if the community has a lot of agencies already there. Kunyari, ikaw lang naman yung NSTP student sa barangay na ito. But during our observation, we found out that there are a lot of organizations. Marami mga church activities na nandun sa loob. So if that's the case, we will choose a different site. Kasi we can see that people, there are a lot of organizations and groups already helping this community. So we need to choose a new place na kailangan talaga ng tulong. Alright, number five is stable peace and order situation. Mahalaga na yung community ay maayos, mapayapa. Kasi we wanted to have our community work as a worthwhile experience at hindi tayo magkakaroon ng traumatic experience. That's why I will ensure that our area have stable peace and order situation. And lastly, accessibility. Dapat malapit lang siya. Considering, kunyari, face-to-face tayo, 7 o'clock na sa LPU gate tayo. Naghihintay tayo na makompleto tayo, no, yung ating klase. Then you are wearing your uniforms, you're wearing your IDs kasi it's required because for a proper identification of the students at para hindi rin ako mahirapan kasi 80 kayo sa klase. Tapos kunyari face-to-face tayo, no, tapos paano ko malalaman kung sino ang estudyante or hindi? That will be the problem, no? Baka mamalooban tayo, baka may modus na magpapanggap siya na estudyante kasi naka-civilian lang naman yung mga students. So that's why it's important to have your uniforms and your IDs with you. Then when we meet by 7 a.m. every Friday in LPU, we will go to the community na malapit lang. It's either Barangay Manggahan or yung mga institutions near our school. Kasi we will travel. No? If we can walk, then we walk. Then by 8 o'clock, dapat nagsisimula na yung ating outreach program. Then by 9 o'clock, we wrap it up. Then by 9 to 10, babalik na tayo ng LPU kasi meron kayong klase after this. So you need to freshen up. Baka pwedeng maghilamos or maghuminga muna, magpahinga, no? Magpababa lang ng temperature kasi mainit sa labas. So that's the importance why accessibility is a consideration. It should be a place near to our university. Now, hindi tayo pupunta sa Tagaytay or sa Dasma, it will be hard for us to travel back and forth. All right, that's pre-immersion. All right, so site selection. And now, we go to the second step. Nakapili na tayo ng lugar. Napili natin ng isang barangay. Now, we will go into enter the community. So, paano po itong enter? This enter isn't a literal na entering na mag-flash mob tayo or mag-fall in line. Entering the community is, how are you going to present yourself? How are you going to introduce yourself? Hello everyone, we are IT, psychology, and LIS students. So paano? How are you going to present yourselves? How are you going to present your program? How are you going to represent our university and to see for the community to see our genuine interest to help them? So entering the community. And entering the community has four ways. Apat na paraan, pero dalawa lang dito yung gagawin natin as NSTP. Number one, this is ostentatious entry. You are complete with banner and a general assembly of the people, then people will be the community ushers. So by here, the community is very supportive. Pumunta ka sa community, provided na lahat. Like meron silang chairs for you, galing sa barangay. Ang barangay nagbigay ng sound system, nagbigay ng place. Tapos yung mga community members, yung mga nanay, halimbawa, nandun na sila. Or kunyari yung bata, yung audience natin, yung mga nanay, will be bringing their kids in the community. So it's ostentatious entry. Hindi ka na mahihirapan dito kasi it is well prepared already by the community. And based on observation, ang mga barangay kasi very supportive yan. Ang mga barangay natin, as long as they are not busy and as long as maganda rin yung programa natin, they will support it. They will provide for all our needs. Like here, this is not a program by a barangay, but this is a program by an organization in an orphanage. So, syempre, pagpunta nila sa orphanage, yung orphanage have prepared for the chairs, have prepared for the sound system, have prepared for the needs, and everything. Dadalhin mo na lang yung sarili mo, yung programa mo, and even the food or the gifts that you will be giving. So, it's an example of ostentatious entry. So, mahalaga na meron tayong partnership with the barangay kasi mapapadali ang trabaho natin. Imagine if we don't have our barangay with us, where will we gathering the people? Or how about the chairs? No, hindi naman tayo pwedeng magrenta tapos bibit-bitin natin papunta ng community. So, this is very important, a partnership. This is ostentatious entry. That's the first one. And I share this with you many times. Ito yung ginagawa namin every Saturday. So, we are gathering kids. Then we are teaching them about Bible stories and values education. And doing feeding program. So here, it started by when we were looking for a site in Alapan 1C in Immersion, Cavite. My sister went to the barangay hall. And she was asking if we can go there and teach kids. And the barangay captain said that he is willing. Yes, we can use our facilities every Saturday para sa community work. Total naman daw yung weekend, hindi naman masyadong madami yung mga tao. So, ang ginawa nila, they provided us with all the things that we need. You can see here, marami kasi kaming classes because the kids were many. They were 50 to 70. So, we need to divide them according to each group. So, here in the example, this is the barangay hall. And this is this one, the photo here on the fourth photo. This is the barangay hall, the lobby. So we are gathering here, the kids are toddlers, and the other group, this is the primary class, they are gathering outside the barangay hall, this is the parking lot, and even this intermediate group, yung mga grades 4 to high school, we are gathering them here naman sa labas ng barangay hall. So this is me, ito lang yung barangay hall, oh, nasa likuran ko lang. So this is an example of an ostentatious entry. Kasi pagpasok namin doon, provided na. And even with our first meeting, nagulat kami kasi nandun na yung mga bata. Nag-gather na ng barangay. As early, we meet kasi by 9 o'clock. And as early daw was 8 o'clock, 1 hour before, people are already... Hindi nakikita yung presentation? Kahit kanina pa? Can you see the first?
Akala ko po video ko yung nag-end po.
Ah, sorry. Kinabahan naman ako.
Hindi po nakikita yung presentation.
Ah, walang PowerPoint?
Sir, wala po.
VG lang po.
Totoo ba?
Kanina pa ako nagsasalit. Meron po sa akin, sir.
Ah, meron sa iba? Bakit ganun?
Baka meron din po sa akin, sir.
I-refresh lang po yata. Ni-refresh ko po yung akin.
Ah, okay. Ay, sige. Refresh. Kinabahan naman ako. Sayang naman yung presentation. Okay, so refresh muna, no? Kasi meron ako sa device ko, it's working eh. I can see the slides. Kinabahan ako. Ayusin muna natin, ha? Okay. All right. Sa ibang class ko naman okay naman eh, na napapanood ko naman yung ano, yung video recorded session. Okay? Just tell me if you can still see it, ah.
Reconnect na lang po ako siguro.
Okay. Thanks again, Josh. Ayan. So, I hope that everyone, others are seeing the presentation. All right? Sabihin lang pag hindi pa rin makita, pero goods naman, sabi naman kita nakita naman. Okay. All right. So, I'll proceed, no? So, ito, no, yung pagpunta namin during our first meeting, the kids are already there an hour before our arrival. They were very excited kasi pandemic days to eh, and the kids don't have their online their face-to-face classes, so the kids are very excited to dress up, to bring their bags, to bring their notebooks and to study, because sabi rin ni Kapitan, namimiss ng mga bata na mag-aral. Eh lang, ang mga bata daw ay nasa kalsada naman kahit pandemya, so why not make it as a time for them to have a worthwhile experience. Well, they're in the pandemic, they have a time to study. So we provided them with materials that they need. And after that, we have feeding program. No? So this is an example of ostentatious entry wherein everything is provided by the partner. And even the mothers are fetching, o yung mga tatay, hinahatid sundo yung mga bata. At pag umuulan, automatic na yan during rainy season, merong tents sa palibot nito. Letter L kasi ito eh. Ito yung katuloy nito eh. So, maraming tents na nilalagay dyan para hindi kami maulanan. So, provided by the barangay. So, this is an example of ostentatious entry. So, ito yung ating first way to enter the community. The other one is banking on people's weakness. Banking on people's weakness is seeing the needs of the people during disaster. And that's the time for you to enter the community. Halimbawa, may bagyo. So what are you going to do to enter the community? Kaso nga lang, medyo hindi natin to gagawin sa NSTP kasi opportunistic to eh. When we say opportunistic, this will not happen according to plan because we don't know when it will come. So we will not be doing a program on banking on people's weakness. And here, ito yung mga ginagawa ng mga organizations na merong budget, yearly budget for a program na ganito. Kasi meron silang huhugoting pera. Pero yung iba naman na walang prepared budget for disasters, yung mga big organizations or yung mga kilalang mga organizations, they do donation drive, yung kanilang GCash link, no, QR codes and even yung mga bank accounts nila online to say that mag-help kayo by sending money. So this is an example of banking on people's weakness. You remember during Taal eruption, ang naging problem dito is that people were asking for cooked food kasi they were receiving a lot of relief goods and they were asking for hot meals. So kung iisipin mo without understanding the people, ang arte naman itong mga evacuees. Binigyan mo na nga ng relief goods ang gusto pa lutuin. But here, take time to understand. They don't have their facilities to cook. They don't have their rice cooker. They don't have their materials and equipment to cook. Wala silang cooking materials. So how anong gagawin nila sa Lucky Me? Anong gagawin nila sa bigas? That's why they were asking for cooked meals na lang ang dalhin sa mga evacuation center. See, if we judge early, no, parang ano ba yan? Pero if we can see that that's their need. Kasi yun yung kanilang hindrance, no? Hindi sila makapagluto. So, we should understand what they need. At may time then that they were asking for us not to give clothes anymore kasi people were very, people have given their clothes, and daming dumating na mga damit sa mga evacuation areas, tas wala nang mapaglagyan yung mga damit, and the people can no longer accommodate more clothes. So they asked na if ever you wanted to still give, you can give new underwear or you can give towels you can give beddings. Yun yung sinabi nila, no, na, na mga needs nila. So, we should just respond, no, kasi sila yung nakakaalam ng kanilang pangailangan. No, sila yung nandun sa situation, eh. So, when they say, ito yung needs namin, yun yung ibigay natin. Huwag nating ipilit na magbigay tayo ng ibang gamit sa kanila. Can you still see the presentation? Good pa tayo? Ayan? Good pa?
Yes po. Yes,
okay,
yes.
Good. Thank you. So, pero alam nyo ba, naalala nyo to, ano bang year to? 2020. So, baka junior high kayo or first year kayo sa senior high. May mga post na ganito na parang naging katuwaan, no? Yung mga tao kasi nabigay sila ng gowns. Tapos ito naman mga kuyang ito, no? Na ang mga Pilipino talaga, they can make a light a situation talaga na mahirap, eh. Kasi anong gagawin mo, magmumukmuk ka, no? Kaya ang ginagawa ng iba, they wanted to entertain themselves. Pero on a serious note, we are a bit bothered with this, no? Kasi the people are giving their gowns, their uniform, yung iba mga costume for them. But here, do they need this right now? Do they need this in their situation in the evacuation center? No. And sir, baka naman may attendant kasi sila next time na mga JS prom or mga events, no? Baka pwede nilang magamit pag nag-apply sila ng work. Mga kaibigan, hindi pa nila iniisip yung mga ganong aspeto sa pagkakataong yon. What they need is a decent clothes. What they need ay mga pambahay or yung mga panlamig kasi malamig or yung mga damit na pwede nilang panimula na pang-alis, no? Pero yung mga ganito, no? Mga Filipiniana, yung iba pa nga nagbigay ng uniform at nakakatuwa nung suot-suot nilang uniform ng fast food chain. At baka sir, kasi meron doon nag-work sa fast food chain, tapos di niya nadala yung uniform niya. Grabe naman, no? Minsan kasi tayo, when we give clothes, it's the easiest way to give. Why? Because it will not cost us anything. It's easy to give if it will not cost you anything. No? Ay, magbigay tayo ng mga damit. Ang dami dyan yung mga luma natin para mag-declutter tayo. But place yourself in the position of these people. If you will be giving those clothes, your old clothes, are you still going to wear that? Ay, hindi na sir. Mukha na siyang basahan. Eh, don't give it. Huwag mong ibigay. No? Pero kunyari, yung mga damit na, pwede ko pa itong masuot, bago pa to, pero hindi ko na kasi siya type, hindi ko na siya style, pero it's still usable, maganda pa yung quality, then give it. Huwag naman na magbigay ng mga butas-butas, no? Baggawin nyo na lang basahan yan. And even are giving their use, yung mga use under, nalabhan naman, okay, use na underwears, no? Pero still, it's not hygienic to give your underwears to other people. No, and that's an important matter, no? When we give, we understand what they need, kung ano yung kailangan nila, no? What they need, and we should listen to them. O, and yung mga nauna ng mga nagbigay, o anong feedback, anong needs nila, no? Hindi na nagbigay sila ng ganito, teka, tatpapantayan natin, gagalingan natin. Hindi naman competition yan, eh. Just try to ask them what happened, what are your feedbacks with regards to the community there in the public elementary school using it as an evacuation center. So it's important, no, not just to give and give, but give what you think is best for them. And ano yun, sabi yun ni King David, no, kay God, no, I will not offer anything that costs me nothing. We will not offer anything that will not giving, yung pagbibigay kasi, it will take something away from you, eh. Talagang pag nagbigay ka, it's really hard kasi it will take something from you. Pero I hope that we are giving as we are giving a part of us, not just because it doesn't wala siyang attachment sa atin or wala siyang say sa atin. Giving is always giving a part of us. So if you wanted to give your clothes, no, yung mga pang-alis nyo na hindi nyo naman madalas ginagamit, at ibigay na lang sa iba, no, nangangailangan. Pero pag sinabi nilang wag na magbigay, hot meals na lang, edi mag-provide na lang tayo ng hot meals for them. So that's banking on people's weakness. Number 3, academic style of entry. This is very self-explanatory. It's a dialogue between the school, the students, and the community. You go there, you represent your school. Hello po, I am Lorenzo. I am from LPU. Hello, I am Ashley. I am an NSTP student from LPU. That's academic style of entry. We are there not just as Sophia or as an individual, but we are there representing our university. So it's a trialogue, university, students, and community. That's academic style. So sa ating case, yung ating option is the academic style and the ostentatious entry. All right? Lastly, people-centered approach. This is hard. Mahirap to kasi this is time-consuming. You wanted to create relationship, relations, ugnayan. Meron tayong i-create na gagawin na effort for us to introduce ourselves as a part of a community. Hindi lamang ito yung basta-bastang pupunta ka ng isang beses or ng isang linggo. This is giving your life for the community. Like this community doctor, this doctor to the barrios. This is an example of a people-centered approach. Why? He spent not just his days, but his long-term, no? His life, no? long-term span in the community. So na-establish niya ngayon yung relationship. Like, hello, I am a doctor and I will be here in your barangay. I will be staying here so that you will have access to health. So that is an example of a people-centered approach. And we cannot do this because this is time-consuming. This will entail a lot of our efforts and a lot of our time. What we wanted only in the community is just to give a simple help to the community and also for us to be exposed for a community work. So people-centered approach will not be an option for us. Here's an example also of what we did with people-centered approach. I don't know if you're familiar with alternative learning system of DepEd. Merong programa ang DepEd kung saan yung mga out-of-school youth will be given a chance to study. Not in a formal schooling, but in a way to have informal classes. Like for example, if ever I stop, I finish first year high school, tapos yun na yung natapos ko. Naging 30 years old na ako halimbawa. Tapos, hindi na ako makabalik, nahihiya na akong bumalik ng second year. Ang ginawa ng DepEd, they have a program called ALS, Alternative Learning System. Na pwede kang mag-enroll sa ALS, you will take 10-month classes. Then after the 10 months, you will take the exam. At pag pumasa ka sa exam na to, graduate ka na ng junior high school. So that is a big help na na-reduce mo yung 3 years sana of your going back to school. At may mga artista na nagumawa nito eh. I think sila Manny Pacquiao, sila Kim Chu. I think nang ALS din sila. No, para magkaroon sila ng magkaroon sila ng promotion. No? They will just undergo series of lessons. No? So here, we started every January or December pa lang we're looking for people. Then they will go to our church, they will do registration, and they will submit all their requirements. Then they will meet. We will meet every Saturday afternoon. So we're going to teach them. Yung mga teachers naman, not necessarily na kami ay mga let pastors, no? Basta nakagraduate ka ng college, no? You can teach the students. So what we did is we're just assigning subjects. Sa akin ang na-assign yung science and values education. So yun yung nabibigay na subject sa akin. Then we teach them for 10 months from January to October. Then during November, they take their accreditation and equivalency test sa DepEd. Then when they pass, usually May nila nire-release yung result eh. When they pass, they will now be graduates. So atin sila graduation, they will be given diploma. Excuse me. And they will now proceed to college. This time kasi wala pang K-12 nito eh. So itong mga students na to, sila yung first batch namin. I think the first batch was 2013. No? Kasi alam ko, pagka-graduate ko, pinagturo agad ako dito. So 2013. So 2013 batch, 2014 graduates, itong mga estudyante na ito. And they passed, and they can now proceed to college. So imagine, no? Pero pag elementary ka naman nag-stop, take ka muna ng elementary elementary test for a year. I mean, elementary module, then a test for a year. And after that, you proceed na with high school. Eh ngayon, may senior high. So I think if they graduate, they can proceed now to senior high school. Kasi before college, you can go to college right away. So, DepEd yan. So pag nag-enroll ka, accredited yung diploma mo kasi galing sa DepEd. So meron din kami mga school programs. So we invite them to church pag Sunday and we can do school programs para ma-appreciate naman nila na merong program na ginagawa, no, na hindi lamang nag-aaral. Meron din kami mga sports day, na sports day talagang may time na nandun kami sa covered court. May mga fellowship and basketball and all these things na pwede nilang gawin para diverse yung ginagawa nila. And by here, we were able to establish not just as part of DepEd or part of the church or the part of the community, but more on coaching them, mentoring them, no, and helping them na makapasa. So this is an example maybe of a people-centered approach. I assume, pwede din siguro pang example ng people-centered approach because it's a long-term one. No? Hindi siya yung isang linggo lang, tapos na, unlike yung gagawin natin with academic style and ostentatious. So that is entering the community. Alright, next, community integration. Now, nakapasok ka na. You have entered in the community. Now, the thing that you need to do is for you to integrate yourself. And when we say integration, it's a continuous process wherein you come into direct contact. You are now involved. O, nakapasok ka na, pinapasok ka na ng community. Now, how are you going to spend your time with the people? And we have three examples on how to do it. Number one is the border style. You may choose to stay or live in. This is what we're going to do. But we will not be staying or living in. We will just stay for an hour. No, pag face-to-face, ibig sabihin, 1 hour per week that multiplied by 5 weeks. So here, you do border style. Meron naman iba, kunyari, if you will go to a research, ipapadala kayo sa Quezon, kunyari. Tapos, you will stay in the community for 2 weeks. And you can ask the barangay captain, Kap, pwede po ba akong magstay po dito? Can I just stay here in the barangay hall to sleep? May mga ginagawa kaming ganun since when I was in DNR. Pag yung area ay very rural, we sleep in the barangay hall. May mga beddings naman sila na pinapahiram sa barangay office. Pag yung mga very rural na walang accommodation for hotel or for rooms. So here, but sir, kapitan, pwede po ba akong magstay here? No, pag nagstay ka sa community, not necessarily na all the things that they do kasi meron kang research eh. So you can go out by during your desired time, tapos magpakilala ka sa community. Tomorrow po I'll be back by 9 o'clock. I will just do some focus group discussion with the team, with your community. So meron ka lang mga scheduled visits with them, pero you live inside also. You live near or inside the community. That's a border style approach. That's the border style. Next thing is the elitist. When we say elitist, this is not what we will be doing in NXTPY. Kasi it's only limited for your key informants and political players. So your social circle is limited. Kagaya nito, pumunta ka lang kay kapitan, hindi ka pumunta sa community. So this is an elitist style because you only go to the community leaders and not to the community. So hindi naman didifik yung purpose natin of community immersion and for us to understand the people kasi ang pinuntahan lang natin si Kapitan. So what we'll be doing is to go to the community. So that's elitist style of integration. And lastly, people-centered method of living with the people. Ito yung kabaliktaran ng border style. Kasi naman sa people-centered method of living with the people, you are there from the time that they wake up hanggang sa pagtulog nila, all the things that they do, you do also. No? So, like, pag gumising sila ng 5, you wake up early. Pag 6 o'clock, they do their farming, you go with them. Or pag sila naman ay pumunta sa bayan, sama ka sa kanila. Kung lights off na sila ng 9 o'clock, tulog time na yung 9, dapat pag 9 o'clock, tutulog ka na rin. So that's an example of a people-centered method of living with the people. All of the things that they do, you do. Like pagbakasyon, nagbabakasyon kayo sa probinsya. Di ba, ganito yung ginagawa natin. What our relatives do? We join them, sama tayo sa kanila. That's an example also of people-centered method of living with the people. No, lalo na pag nagbakasyon ka sa amin kasi sa Ilocos, pag nagbabakasyon kami, maaga kasi nagigising yung mga tao. So maaga ka din magigising kasi you can hear the people talking. So gising ka na maaga. Merong ano yan eh, may time na magwo-walking, sasama ka, you join them. No, it's a people-centered method of living with the people. Pero yung mga community work, talagang immersion, yun yung in-depth, like lahat ng gagawin ng community talaga, you will be with them. So you have an activity 3, share ko na lang din kasi this is the best time to share it. You have activity 3 in the course, right? And it's about a community work that you had before. It's either you had it when you were in high school or during your involvement in the church, or meron kayong organization na may ginawang community work, or meron kayong personal na ginawa, like during the pandemic, you give out some hygiene kits or nagbigay kayo ng pagkain sa frontliners. You can do that as you're sharing. Pero kung talagang zero, kung wala talagang experience sa community work, what you can do is to share a vacation experience. Halimbawa, nagbakasyon ka sa Cebu, nagbakasyon ka sa Bicol, what have you experienced? What have you learned? Alright? What have you learned from the people, from the food, from the interaction, from their behavior or their attitude, their way to accept people, no? So ano yung napansin mo? Pero wag naman yung detail like day one. Wag mo nang i-share yon, no? You just share what where did you go? What have you learned? What have you observed? No? And even with the community work, when it happened, kung gusto mo lagyan ng pictures, pwede mo naman lagyan. Pwede ka naman mag-attach ng photos sa course site, no, sa forum. Wag na kayo mag-attach ng Word file or PDF file. Kasi time consuming kasi on my part to download pa. Kasi pag hindi mo siya na-download, you cannot read it, no? So I hope that you understand. Just share it. You wanted it to have photos. Pero kung walang photos, okay lang. You can still get a perfect score without photos as long as you shared the story and what have you learned from that experience. So that's your activity 3, community integration. So that's community integration. Now we proceed with the last two. The fourth one, community needs assessment. This is important. We need to have community needs assessment. And I mentioned this last time, na pagpunta mo sa community, you wanted to understand their problem, their issues and concerns. So how are we going to do this? We will be giving out survey forms, questionnaires, or we can do key informant interview. When we do key informant interview, i-interview mo si Kapitan, interview mo si Lola, interview mo si teacher. Pero may isa naman, focus group discussion or FGD. Focus group discussions naman, ito yung may nakita kang group of nanay. Hello po mga nanay, can I just take your few minutes and we'll just have a short kwentuhan lang? Or may nakita kang grupo ng mga bata, you gather them and ask them about their situation. So it's a focus group discussion. So you can get the people's perspective by doing that. No, pakikipag-usap sa kanila. Then that's the time na babalik tayo sa school, we'll do brainstorming and choose a program for the community. So it should be reflecting their sentiments, their needs, and their aspirations, and the recommendations of the community people. And lastly, it should be their perception, not your perception. Because it's for them. No, dapat perception mo, perception nila, yung nandun sa programa. Because that's community needs assessment. For us to ensure that the program is suitable for them and the program is sustainable. Alright? So this slides pala, I'll be sharing this with you. Medyo may mga parts na mabilis ako maglipat ng slide. This will not be part of your exam. Okay, your exam will be output based. This is not, this is just part of your understanding. And you can apply this during your exam for the prelims. But I will not be asking output, objective type exam here, like define this and identification. Wala naman. Okay? So here, ito, meron na akong halimbawa na ginawa namin nung ako'y nag-college. No NSTP. Ano yung sir yung ginawa yung community work? Ito na nga ang aming failed community work. So, when I was in college, you know, I sa UP kasi we don't have Monday classes. So wala kaming klase pag Monday. Monday is allotted for NSTP. Monday is allotted for major subjects. So kung first year ka, 4 days ka lang papasok, no? So, pero may NSTP. So I decided not to take it kasi madali kasi ako ma-homesick, no? During my first week in college, talagang umiiyak ako sa dorm kasi nalulungkot ako, no? Pero habang tumatagal, nawawala naman yung pagiging homesick. Pero ang ayoko lang talaga, I don't want to stay in the dormitory if I don't have class for that day. Kasi malaking bagay rin na pagtitipid. Kasi syempre, pag nandun ka, you go there day before your classes, syempre meron ka pang gagastos sa pagkain, and pag na-temp ka pa, you wanted to go somewhere. So what I did during the Monday, I don't go to Los Baños, to Laguna. So I just stay here inside my house. So for my first 3 years, hindi ako nag-take ng NSTP kasi you have the freedom kasi sa amin when to take it. Basta yung mga major subjects mo, you take it according to the desired semesters. Pero yung ibang mga subjects, pwede mong kunin kahit kailan mo. Pwede kang mag-mix and match ng subjects or pwede kang magplano kung nyari gusto mo kunin siya ng ganitong taon or ng ganito. Or yung mga ganung aspects, no? Yung kunyari, pili ka ng mga fun subjects during your third year and fourth year para medyo feel good na lang yung mga subjects. Yung ganun yung ginagawa namin. So during my preparation of my program, I put NSTP during fourth year. At it's a wrong decision kasi lahat ng classmates ko freshmen. At yung mga classmates ko, na batchmates ko, tapos na sila ng NSTP first year pa lang sila. So what I did is, I attend classes every Monday, 7 to 10 kami. Then, hindi ko maalala yung mga great experiences kasi yung teacher ko hindi nagtuturo during NSTP. She always wanted us to watch videos, film showing, then uwi na agad. So, medyo hindi masyadong memorable sa akin yung NSTP time ko. And that's the time na ngayon, NSTP 2 na, we were asked to create a an innovation. Gumawa kayo ng innovation. Gumawa kayo ng isang simpleng produkto na magagamit ng community. Tapos kami, wala kaming foundation because we did not had this community needs assessment. So wala kaming pagpunta sa community. So sabi nila ng teacher namin, gawa kayo ng innovation. Parang kami, ha? Ano bang gagawin natin? Yung mga classmates ko, kanya-kanya na silang isip. Merong nag-isip ng toothpaste squeezer. Like may kahoy na may kahoy, tapos may hiwa siya sa gitna, tapos papasok mo rin yung toothpaste tube, sa squeezer na yon. Pero kung iisipin mo, anong basis nila ng paggawa nun? So yung first visit namin with the community, it's that time na ibibigay namin, donate namin yung product sa kanila. Eh yung mga tao, natuwa naman sila dun sa toothpaste squeezer kasi medyo magagamit mo naman siya. Pero kami, ito nga ang ginawa namin, multi-purpose cabinet. Eh yung squeezer, napakaliit lang. Eh yung sa amin, napakalaking cabinet, mga kaibigan. So hindi ko alam kung pumasok sa isipan ng mga kaklasik kong mga first year students na bakit cabinet ang gusto nilang i-donate sa community. And we will be bringing this to a community near the university. So pupunta kami, mag-jeep kami, magpe-pedicab kami, maglalakad kami para madarating ang Gawad Kalinga, GK community. And what we did is a multi-purpose cabinet. So here's the catch. We went to the community at ang target namin is to give it to a daycare center. So kumatok kami, nagkaklase pa si teacher na istorbo siya, and we said, ma'am, we have here a multi-purpose cabinet para po sa inyo. Siyempre si teacher, ha, bakit niya ako bibigyan ng cabinet? But all of a sudden, may kakatok na mga estudyante and will give me a cabinet. And she said na, our place is already crowded and we will not be able to use it. We have a lot of cabinet here. And we push it. Sabi niya, sige ma'am, kunin mo na para makaawa na lang kami na para matapos itong NSTP na to kasi graduating na ako nun eh. So sabi namin kay ma'am, kunin niyo na lang po. So the coming week, we went there again for an evaluation. How did the program help you? So when we went there, hi teacher, kami po yung mga pumunta last week. What happened to our cabinet? She said, we disposed it. Tinapon namin. Kasi nasira siya agad. And we don't have space for it. Hindi ko tuloy alam kung nagsabi lang si teacher na nasira agad o pinamigay niya sa mga neighborhood. Kasi nga, hindi siya mahalaga for them. So when we went back to our classroom, we had the report, and I was the one who gave the report, and I said it was a failure because we were not able to know the sentiments of the people, and they did not use it because they don't need it. So it's the need for a community needs assessment. Mahalaga na malaman mo ang pangangailangan ng community. Kung nalaman namin kung ang target talaga namin ay daycare center, we could have thought of an activity or a product na medyo mas kailangan ng mga estudyante sa daycare. So hindi sana yung cabinet yung interest namin. So see, that is the importance of having community needs assessment. Last two, program and project implementation. When we say program and project implementation, ito na yun, self-explanatory, you implement it. It's the actual execution of the program. So that's implementation. So here, it should be smart. Alam nyo na yung smart na yan. Specific, measurable with measurement, achievable, relevant, and time-oriented. When we say specific, talagang dapat cert, talagang very to the details ka. Halimbawa, you wanted to go at tutorial classes. Sir, ang plano namin, by week 1, we teach English, week 2, we teach math, week 3, we teach science. And we're talking about 1 hour per week only. And that will not be good for the students kasi ang daming programs. So what we can do is to ask the parents what subject na ang mga bata ay nahihirapan. And when they say, sa mathematics po, then we teach math. No? And the question, what specific topic? You need to be specific. Baka naman ituro mo addition. Grade 6 na pala sila. So we need to be specific. What will be the age group? What will be our audience? Then what specific topic for us to study it? No, ano yung particular nating ituturo sa kanila? No, that we need to be specific. Number 2, measurable with measurement. How can we measure na successful yung math tutorial natin? Sir, pag nakangiti yung mga bata, math class, hindi talaga ngingiti yung mga batang yan. I assume because I don't like math. No? So, measurable with measurement. How can you measure that your math tutorial is successful? No? Here, sir, napansin namin, during the first day, they know how to add 1-digit numbers. 4 plus 3, 8 plus 1. Pero when you have it 2 digits, they cannot do it. 12 plus 11, 23 plus 48, di nila magawa. So what we need to do is to teach them how to do it. So when we found out after the 5th lesson, sir, napansin namin yung mga estudyante, they know now how to add 2-digit numbers. O ilan sila? Sir, mga 7 out of the 10 kids. O di 70%, nagkaroon ka ng success rate kasi they were able to have a progress. So measurable with measurement. Hindi pwede yung gusto ko magpa-Zumba, sir, Zumba program for the nanays. At ang Zumba program mo, you wanted them to reduce weight. Hindi naman madaling mag-reduce ng weight sa mga nanay, no? So it's not measurable. Sir, paano magkakaroon ng measurement ang Zumba program? Di tanungin mo sila, during Friday morning lang ba sila nag-Zumba? Or ginagawa nila every day? Pag sinabi nila, we do it every other day. We do it twice a week. Na, yung isang beses doon yung ating meeting sa NSTP. So it's you can measure the success there. Kasi nakita mo, nagiging sustainable. Hindi lamang sila nag-workout pag nandyan tayo. They also do their workouts even though we are not there. So that's measurable with measurement. Next is achievable. Dapat hindi suntok sa buwan, hindi imposible. Kagaya nga nung halimbawa natin, nagpa-Zumba ka, ang gusto mong result, pumayat yung mga nanay. Hindi naman natin magagawa yun with our NSTP program. Or ang gusto mo siguro magturo yung sex bomb dancers, hindi naman pwedeng sila yung magtuturo ng Zumba, no? Kayo-kayo rin yun, no? Kayo-kayo yung gagawa nun, no? Sila Andrea yung magtuturo ng Zumba with the nanays, if ever. Ganun yun, hindi yung kukuha tayo ng mga dancers. Kayo-kayo yun. Alright? Kayo-kayo lahat ang gagawa nun, even with the MC, with the hosting, with the program, kung may tutorial, the teaching, all of these things, you do it. So wala tayong i-recruit. And it should be achievable. No, madaling ma-achieve, madaling makuha, makamit. No, hindi siya suntok sa buwan, hindi siya impossible to do. Okay, achievable. Number 4 is relevant. Relevant. Ito nga yung sinasabi ko kanina. Yung ginawa namin, hindi relevant sa NSTP 2. wala siyang silbi sa community. So your program should be relevant. And lastly, time-oriented. Dapat take note that time. Ilang linggo lang ba nandun? Ilang araw lang ba nandun? So dapat yung programa mo, hindi yung pang matagalan ang resulta. So you need just to do, kunyari sa time-oriented, hindi mo na madi-discuss lahat ng math subjects. You focus only on one. Then you made them expert of that one topic. Kung puro tayo addition, then you go. This week, addition. Next week, we have also addition. Next week naman, medyo creative naman yung presentation natin. Yung addition natin is in a way of fruits or objects, no? Pero one topic lang, addition. No, wag na tayong maging diverse sa topics kasi it will not be time-oriented. Alright? So, implementation. And finally, yes, last na, termination of the project. Ending. Tapos na. You terminate it. You end the program. But it's important for you to end the program well. Hindi nyo pwedeng sabihin na, okay mga bata, this is our last day of our math tutorial. Wala na tayo next week. Hindi pwedeng ganun. Dapat you have a program to culminate it. For example, mga bata, this will be our last tutorial class. Next week will be our graduation day. May graduation day sila. At yun yung ginagawa rin namin sa mga bata sa community. Before we choose another site, we do a graduation. So kung usual namin pinapakain sa mga bata ay lugaw, lomi, champorado, tsaka sopa. So yun yung apat na yung paikot-ikot lang yung pagkain na yun eh. Kasi favorite nila yun, yung mga bata. Pero pag last day or nung Christmas din, ang ginawa namin, ang pagkain naman, spaghetti tsaka fried chicken. Siyempre special eh. So kung last day na, kung ang usual pakain ng com namin sa community ay ganun, pag last day, special na yung food. Tapos we ask them to wear your best clothes. Tapos you go here, you can bring your parents with you because you will be giving awards. And if you have 20 students, give awards for everyone. Huwag yung may limang hindi nabigyan. Eh, syempre, iiyak yan eh. Or part yan ng kanilang core na parang, ay, nung bata ako, hindi ako nabigyan ng award. Lahat nabigyan. So, kunyari, sir, kasi ang kulit, ang playful niya. Eh, the most playful, sir, yung isa talaga ang dal-dal nung isang hindi nakikinig. Hindi gawin siya most friendly. Isip ka ng mga awards na mag-invento ka na ng mga awards na fit sa kanilang mga ano, kanilang mga personalities. Pero syempre, yung magagaling, you give them best in class, mga ganon, no? Or best in recitation, no? Most active, most behave. Oh, isa naman din kasi salita, ibigay mo na most behave. So, you end it well. Tapos mayroong intermission number, pwedeng may intermission number kayo ng mga teachers, or pwedeng you ask the students to have intermission number, or to ask them to know how to do their counting, or may magpe-present na mag-a-add siya sa board. No, meron siyang i-add na mayroon siya solve na problem dun sa board. No? So it's an example of termination of the project. It's important to end well the program. And lastly, ito na lang, last na. When I was second year college, we partnered with an organization, American organization. It's called the Operation Christmas Child. So what we did, no, sa aming Operation Christmas Child is that yung mga people from America, they were preparing gifts, shoeboxes, and they will be giving it to different countries. And during that time, I think it's 2011, hindi ako sure kung 2010 or 2011, pero yung mga time na yon, ang ibinigay nila ay sa Philippines. At meron silang mga ibinigay na thousands of shoeboxes in Cavite. And what we did, we were the one asked to distribute it. So what we did is we chose different public elementary schools in Imus, Cavite para bigyan namin ng mga shoeboxes. So we did our pumunta kami sa community sa school, tapos meron kaming mga program na ginawa. Ano, hindi ka lang doon para ito yung regalo. Meron kaming program, may teaching, we teach about salvation, we teach about the gospel with the kids, then we have feeding program. We made it as a worthwhile experience for the kids because the kids will understand it. So yung mga graduation na yan, yung mga gift-giving na yan, then the kids can remember it. Naalala nila yan. It will be part of familiar sa akin yung ginagawa mo no sa community. So ay nawala yung presentation, no? So it's the end naman na, no? So familiar sir yung ginagawa mo sa community. So and she asked many questions and she found out na confirm niya na sir kami yung nabigyan mo ng gift tong bata pa ako nung grade 6 ako. Sabi ko, ganun ba ako katanda? Yung tinuruan ko nung dati ay college na. At sabi niya, sir, ako yung nabigyan mo ng gift before. I remember you asked us na mag-blindfold. Tapos nung tinanggal namin yung blindfold namin, may regalo sa harapan namin. Then we did our teachings. No? May mga weekly teachings din kami. Then yung certificate nga, sir, nasa akin pa rin. Tinago ko siya kasi sa memorable day for me. So you see, these things, naalala yan ng mga bata. Kahit na tapusin mo yung programa na wala ka man ng effort to finish it, the kids will understand, will remember it. But if you make it, if you give your best to be dedicated and giving a good program to culminate that community work with the kids, it will be a memorable experience to them. So, yun, no? Yun yung ating, yun yung